So we are in our application. We've been rendering that front HTML form. That's what we've been editing. Let's go ahead and add our post function to deal with what the user types to us. Okay, so we add the post function. First thing we need to do is get the parameters out of the request. Self.request get title and self.request get art. And that will get those values from the post, from the form submission. Let's go ahead and add some basic error handling. Okay, so I've added the shell of our kind of error handling. So if we have both a title and art, for now we're just going to say thanks. You know, that's just a stub. If we don't have a title and art, we're going to say we're going to set this error variable, and then we're going to render the form with our error message. So I'm going to pass the error variable I made into this function render, and which is going to pass it to our template. And so we need to add a place for our error in our template. Let's put this right at the bottom of the form. Okay, so I've made a basic div. I'm going to call it class error because I have intentions of styling this later to make the text red. And classes are how we attach CSS styles to things. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say curly curly error. Close curlies, and I'm going to close this div. Now, what this does, this is part of our template language. This includes any variables that the template is rendered with. It'll render them right in place here. So this is a little bit nicer than the string substitution thing we were doing before. And while I'm in here, I'm going to go ahead and add a submit button because we forgot that before. So we're going to give this a test. Here we are in our form. If I click the submit button without submitting anything, we render our form and we see our error message. That's perfect. If I type in just a title and I click submit, again, the form with the error message, just the art, perfect. And now if I type in both, I see thanks. Okay, so it looks like this thing is working. One thing I want you to notice is when I type in text in the text field and I hit submit and we get our error, we lost our text. Remember, we've dealt with this before. So let's go ahead and fix that bug while we're sitting here. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pull out the rendering of the front page into its own function because we're going to be calling it from both get and post, and I don't want to have some of this logic that we're about to write duplicated. So let's go ahead and add a new function to our class. So let's create a new class called renderFront, and this is going to render our front page. It's going to take in a few parameters. How about the title, which will default to nothing. The artwork, which will also default to nothing. And the error message, which also will default to nothing. And all this function is going to do right now is it's going to call self.render front.html. And we're going to pass in title equals title, art equals art, and error equals error. All we're doing here, and you should remember the structure, I hope, from the previous lesson, we're just taking this variable title and passing it in to the template. And so we can use these variables in the template when we're rendering our form. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace this call of self.render to self.renderFront. That'll draw the blank form. And then I'm going to replace this call to self.render to self.renderFront. And this will render our form with the error message. And one final thing we need to do is actually make use of these variables. So let's go ahead and do that. Here we are in our input for the title. Let's preserve the title. So I'm going to include the title variable passed in from the other function. And then in our text area, I'm going to include any art that was passed in. OK, let's give this all a test. Reloading this page doesn't break anything. If I type in a title, and we're going to test our error submission, and I click submit, we should see our error message, and we should see title still in the title box. OK, we see our error message. We don't see title in the title box. Let's go investigate why.